Hi, and welcome back to Dungeon of the Endless. I'm Fwop, and we're going down in level 3. There are 32 doors this time, 121 monsters killed, and more sciencing got done. I also recruited a third hero, so things are looking good. So now I've got a robot who seems to be a great hard point, very tough, tanky, with a damaging skill and a lot of nice stay in one place and defend it skills. We got an explorer, an eternally optimistic and terrified extra loot gatherer. A very thrifty hero, which I really like. He's not quite my major damage dealer at the moment anymore, but he's definitely kitted out. And I've got a knight without a horse, who is an excellent damage dealer and quite tough, and also cheap to level up. She's an unlock 1 of 3. I'm not sure what that means, but we'll see. That's something that's not on my other heroes. Perhaps it's permanent access to her if I keep her for at least 3 levels, something like that. We'll see. Anyway, I have yet to find a spear, and there's going to be great demand for spears. I have 2 doors. I've gone up, down. I think left is the appropriate thing, and I'm starting to learn the importance of the space bar. Alright, a dust room with a t-shirt, 9 defense, hit point max plus 60, speed minus 2. Okay. It be bonus hit points, same defense as the chitin, a little less speed. The tank, it would increase her DPS. She's kind of tanky, she has high defense. It's not really worth putting on this guy. The extra health is nice, he has the highest defense. Alright, let's put it on our tank. And it's about, this guy needs more defense, I'm afraid. I did trade 9 DPS for 9 attack, which kinda sucks. Maybe that's not worth it. For only 6 attack, I trade 9 DPS. For her, in that case, let's put the t-shirt on him. The health isn't worth as much, but his damage doesn't go down, and he finally gets some decent defense. Power this. How many nodes does it have? 3. Not a perfect defensive zone, but we've got a little exploring leeway. Now let's see. It is time to build an industry generator. We'll have him operate it. And we'll explore. There's just a little dust. I can leave that industry operating room going and head out this way. Or I can look for a good choke point. There are a lot of doors here, which means eventually it's going to be a rough space, unless I explore and power the rooms. Exploring this way will Can definitely clear the room. It'll be right next to my crystal, which means I can power it without fear. And I'll know what's there. And I won't have explored. Okay, I think exploring at least the rooms next to your crystal is kind of important. That is lame. However, it's also a one-way path. I can use this hero to beast a little bit. So let's open one of these. I can actually generate dust by beasting some. Let's go up since we went down last level. Alright, industry. Okay, this is an excellent defensive place. I'm not sure I need... Oh, I should have built more. Oh, I couldn't. Leveling or science? You know, I've got a good bit of science. I've been doing mad science work. I would like to level up. And then I can explore with just one, huh? What is his wit at? 8? So I expect 4 extra food from him sitting there. What are his abilities? He can get me a little extra dust when he personally explores, which is something I'm not doing because I'm using this character. Let's see, this guy can... I'm gonna leave him on industry, and he can fight at least one room worth of baddies all by himself. Lots of dust here. Self-powered room. Perfect. Yep, I did get 4 extra food from him. Level her up. She'll get another active ability. Food costs are so cheap. Let's really exploit this food cost of hers. I'm gonna build that. Do I want to switch to pure food generation or energy? Let's keep production high. Build one more. Let's build another food replicator. beast one more of these. Okay. Just a room. Ooh, a dead end, no less. Well, in that case, let's move up here. It's powered, so I don't have to fear attack from behind. I've got all my major points covered. I can build up industry for automated defenses. We'll go ahead and blow this passive since I'm gonna leave him sitting here for a little while. Oh, that was unnecessary. Can't build a major module, don't really want to, so I don't feel bad about not powering this. I want to build up some industry. This guy's got pretty serious damage, so tear gas could be exceptionally useful right there. So we'll splurge for one of those. Level her up. Her active is hold the line. All heroes in the room get 80 extra defense, which is crazy. All monsters in the room, there's a really strong chance that they will not drop dust. Dust loot probability for monsters minus 60. All of them in the room, not just her target. Okay, so she's incredibly beasty. Everyone in the room becomes incredibly beastie. Oh, and the cooldown is 2. It's very short. But you can kind of suck yourself dry of dust. So I've got tear gas in there. This is just going to be a major choke point. It just seems pretty obvious. So I'm going to put a heal. A Tesla. Should I just leave this room unpowered? No, let's explore some. Let's go left. One wave incoming. Come and get it. That's right. She'll just suck up dust, so there's no point. Self-powered room. Damn, guys, this is too easy, I say. Stupidly. I actually want the dust. I want to go one further that way. No, not really. If I keep it sealed off, maybe it can survive and I can hide a generator in there. He rocks the hard point. 40, look at that next round. him take these things out with his mad attack abilities. And he can eat beast the waves. It looks like there are hero killers. They haven't attacked the minor modules and they've actively hunted down my character. I can power two rooms. Just go straight up with this one, who is so cheap to level. We'll max her out. Now what? More food? Now the waves will become super intense up here. Keep going up. Not a dead end. Gork the Butcher Crozer arranged. From what I know, a dumb ranged weapon user. Yeah, we'll take him. Let's look at him. Psycho Killer, active skill, attack power plus 15, speed plus 12, duration 7 seconds, cooldown 2. Nice. Polite people call it Berserker Rage. He has machine guns. His defense sucks, so a prison uniform suits him. Machine guns. Oh, he's extremely high damage per second. More damage per second than any of my other characters, even at level 1. Long attack range. Extremely low wit. It's okay, I've got two operators and two fighters now. So he's DPS. She's tank. Reinforce. Alright, this looks like a good combo. Yeah, let's keep exploring this way. Thank God, a dead end. Well, that seemed to be that. Oh wait, it's not. Well, whatever. Ah, Gork is super slow. We can max out how many waves this guy's dealing with before heading to the right. like it. This seems like plenty. Too many waves might merge. Like, you know, this room and this room might merge, and you might hit a double wave. So it's like one wave, a wave of two. I might be able to handle that. I can power up a lot of these rooms. I don't think I have to. I think I'll actually get more dust by killing things. So let's see how greedy we can get then. Try and max out our dust production. Although dust isn't worth anything at the end of the game. Let's go ahead and put a claymore. So we've got defense, heal, Tesla, claymore, claymore. Alright, so we're just gonna bank on that room. Oh. Not a repairer. Wealth or death? 30 more for now. Probably only one room here. Let's go in this direction instead. I'm gonna expand this one so I can see if anyone's going for my module. Okay, I'm gonna lose that module if I'm not careful. Or I can trade food to keep it, basically. I'm gonna have to keep defending that module. Poorly, no less. So it's kind of poorly placed. That's a dead end. Let's pull her back. Yeah, that wasn't gonna happen, was it? Guaranteed at least three more doors. Let's level him up. Food plus 0.1 by killed monster. Okay, every time he kills a monster, he generates food, because he's creepy. Okay, so I should have been lessening the waves by powering rooms. That would have saved me that. I don't think that's terribly necessary anymore. 1, 2, 3. That can make for a pretty big wave. This guy should just stay here. He is too slow. Is there anything in here? Not really. Wealth or death? Let's save it for last. There's the exit. Her out of it to maximize our dust, although I have so much dust. It's nice that she is quick. Warcry, defense plus 70 for himself, all monsters attack him. And he's really tough. Yay, a spear. Boo, rapier. Yay, six gun. And a lucky rabbit's foot. I want so many of these, and I can have all of it. Here is a better six gun. Here is a lucky rabbit's foot, as it helps with his tankiness and his production of industry. And a badass spear. Increase my DPS to ridiculous levels. And then you can only have four heroes at a time. So I'm never gonna need this. I'm never gonna need that, unfortunately. However. Treasure chest. Soul Taker. Pretty sure never gonna need that, right? Okay, how are they doing? Come on. They're fine. Soul Taker is a sweet dagger. Not something I need. You cannot buy back for the price you sold stuff, so be careful. So I'm racking up dust. I guess if I get another merchant, that'll be great. Doesn't seem very likely. But I can handle the monsters from this end. And what does this one do? Minor modules on floor do 80% extra attack damage. Hero's attack power is 50% less, and it lasts for 7 turns. Well, that's lame. Passive. He gets nothing. Let's see what her passive is. What's this? Iron Fist. Okay, this is that spear. Attack power plus 3 for each other hero in the room. Nice. And her level 8 passive is Energivore. Health regen plus 13 in unpowered rooms with monsters. And that was the last door. Oh, and there's a research. Well, too late to use it even once. The hordes of monsters are coming. I can go ahead and send him up. Alright, I noticed it's best to watch your health up here in the top right, as with all this stuff in here, it gets really hard to figure out what's going on. We're gonna crush these dudes. No point in preserving dust. That's all I needed. Don't care about that room. Don't care about that room. He's going here. That's fully done. This is probably the only place they need to worry about. Oh yeah. Sure. plus 20 dust. Well, that wasn't worth it. Alright, so that's pretty much what that does. Dust factory may produce dust, is my guess. For a ton of industry. Alright, so that was 52 doors. The doors are obviously ramping up. Monsters killed, 235. Lots of science made because I didn't explore one to the right and notice the science thingy that was so close. In a dead end. Ah, well. Alright, so I will stop the video here, and I will see you next floor. Thanks for watching.